Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Enderal. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading Lyrical Gushes and Other Fluids, a guide to Prince Mith's poems. Which I found in the detention cells here in Rivervale. Storm and Stress, a guide to the collected works of Prince Andreu of Mith. Composed by G.A. V.M. Prince Andreu of Mith is without a question among the most prominent poets of our time. Countless intellectuals from all over Vin have already traveled to Ark, his adoptive home, in hopes of listening to the artist's passionate lectures. Skillfully, he combines classical metric with ardent primeval onomatopoeia, thus giving utterance to his innermost feelings in unprecedented manner. And yet, a highly regarded Kyrenian scholar called his works at times extremely challenging even for a learned mind. Wishing for an aid to interpreting the intellectual outpourings of the literary lightborn. This booklet accomplishes exactly that purpose. It shall assist the inclined friend of poetry in achieving deeper understanding for Prince Andreu of Mith's flashes of genius. A warning beforehand, if the books of Jornash Schmid should belong to your collection, you should give this book to the flames at once, as Mith's visionary thoughts will remain sealed to you anyway. Opus 1. In the Shackles of Lust. On rocks I stood, amidst the sea, before me nymphs of ancient times. Oh yes! Sensual and sweet as sin, their bodies touch my tender skin. Oh yummy! Tastes like cherries. Lo, how their bosoms make me languish, and leave my poet's heart in anguish. Woe, woe! Away, away, away you go. They purse their lips, so dark and red, such scheming play, such vexing hex. Brute lust. With strongest will, my soul so small, I fled their calling, after all. Yippee! The poet here unambiguously recounts a seafarer's struggle against the seductions of the fire nymphs who live among the coves and bays of the sea with the same name. Witty but gentle still, he conjures up powerful images in the first stanza, adding a dramatic touch by utilizing words such as gone, sea, and times, and thereby reminding us of the era of Enderalian epics. But as soon as we are lulled into false security by his aptly chosen words, he surprises us with an apparent breach in style. The lines shout at us with archaic power, arousing emotions of insatiable lust and temptation. The renowned genius drags us even further into the vortex of sexuality in the next stanza, where he eloquently describes how the nymphs, full of femininity, attempt to drive the lyrical self to them and certain death. For a short moment the hero breaks down as the words, oh yummy, tastes like cherries, show. Full of sarcasm, they point to the primeval helplessness a beautiful man or woman, according to preference, can put us in. By choosing the cherry, our poet consciously uses a sensual fruit to create a connection with the second line, symbolizing the relentless predicament our hero now finds himself in. Should he take to the fruit, or to flight? Thinking of his companion and home in Ark, the poet then increases the cunning seafarer's anguish beyond measure as the nymphs ecstatically rub themselves on his body, making him feel their full, well-formed lust buds. The guttural sounds also convey the endless anguish now spreading in the speaker's heart for the first time. Woe, woe, away, away, away you go. Finally, the wicked poem achieves its emotional climax in the fourth stanza. While the lecherous mermaids continue in their attempts to drag the seafarer with them in the abyss, a stream of doubts, existential angst, and wayless temptation erupts in his head. Brute lust. Here it shall be remarked that the poet only reluctantly added the words brute lust so as to make the theme of his literary masterpiece easier to grasp for his not as well-read but well-meaning fellow intellectuals, a virtue found in precious few poets speaking for the prince's human greatness. Then, the delighted reader, engaged by the heartbreaking epic struggle of an honest man with his primeval instincts, is finally released. In order to avoid leaving the emotionally exhausted mind of the reader in the real world in an all-too-melancholical condition, the genius adds a tired yippee to the second-last line, a despaired yet relieved exclamation of the brave seafarer who will never forget his fateful encounter with the lecherous demonesses. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Enderal, Lyrical Gushes, and Other Fluids, a guide to Prince Mith's poems.